Hello and welcome to Eastbury Community School. My name is Mrs. Oberholzer and I'm the Transition Coordinator here at ECS. We are so pleased that you've chosen Eastbury and we can't wait to show you around. Mr. Reed will be giving you your guided tour this morning, so let's go and meet him.
Hello Year 7, welcome to Eastbury. It's such a shame that I can't see you in person on the transition day and that I have to show you around the school this way. But so be it, it just means that I'm even more excited to see you when you arrive in September. Now when you do arrive, you obviously have been introduced by Mrs. Oberholzer. You'll come into the hall and you'll be seated at these seats here, as you can see, where you will be put into your respective form rooms. Once you've been put into your respective form rooms, you'll be called out to be taken to those form rooms, which we're going to go and have a look at now, if you'd like to come with me. Right, so we're at the Wilmington building now. When you get to this stage, there are no coats on allowed in the building, so just make sure that you take your coat off as you enter. We're going to head up to the first floor where your form rooms are going to be, so let's go and have a look. Okay, so we've made it to the first floor of Wilmington. This is where your form rooms are going to be. Most of your form tutors are maths teachers, so that's why we use the maths corridor as our form classes. We're going to go and have a look at one of those rooms now. If you want to just go and take a look in there, you can see this is one of our standard maths classrooms. Nice and big, nice and spacious, plenty of storage at the back for all your books and all your work on the walls. And a lovely view of the school field, which we'll take a look at a little bit later on.
Hi, I'm Miss Ali Khan. I'm a maths teacher and I'm going to be a 7th form tutor next year. And I'm looking forward to welcoming you all to Eastbury.
Hi, 70. I'm Miss Bilabi and I'm going to be a form tutor. Can't wait to meet you all.
Hello Year 7s, my name is Mr. Carew. I'll be one of your form tutors next year. Can't wait to see you guys.
Hi Year 7, I'm Miss Chowdhury. I'm the form tutor for 7Y. We all look forward to seeing you guys in September.
Hello, I'm Mr. Carpenter. I'm going to be one of the form teachers next year and I look forward to meeting you.
Hi 7D, my name is Miss Hunt. I'll be your form tutor next year and I can't wait to meet you all.
Hello Year 7, my name is Mr. Rupra. I'm going to be taking you guys next year. I'm really looking forward to meeting you all.
Hi Year 7, it's Miss Martin. I'm one of your form tutors and I can't wait to meet you all.
Hello guys, I'm Mr. Tolo. I will be a form tutor next year when you come to Eastbury.
Hi, I'm Miss Nelson. I'm going to be a form tutor for 7R. Can't wait to see you all.
Hello, just wanted to introduce myself. My name is Mrs. Traylor. I am going to be one of your form tutors next year. I hope you have a lovely summer and look forward to meeting you all in September.
Okay, right, so we've made it to the second floor of Wilmington, which is the science corridor, complete with many labs like the one that you can see here. It's complete with gas taps and seats to the side for you to conduct your experiments safely in class. Right now, we're going to head back downstairs, right the way to the bottom floor, and have a look at the English rooms. Okay, so we're now at the ground floor of Wilmington, but as you can see, it's quite familiar on each floor. It's exactly the same set out on all three floors of this building, which will help you familiarise yourself from the first day. So we've seen maths, we've seen science, now we're downstairs looking at English. Let's go and have a look at a classroom. Okay, we're now in an English classroom. As you can see, much the same as the maths rooms that you've seen so far. Nice and spacious, laid out exactly the same way with the storage at the back. One thing you may not have seen so far though is the interactive whiteboard that is in every single classroom in the school to help you with your learning. Okay, we've looked around Wilmington now. We're going to head out towards the playground and we're going to head towards the main building. Okay, we're now outside. As you can see, we've got our nice big sport field here. This is perfect for both your PE time and your break times and your after school sports clubs. We've got the long jump pit over there. We currently have the athletics track markings here with the football goals in place as well as a rounders pitch over there. It's absolutely perfect environment for your break times, for your learning in PE and for your after school sports clubs as mentioned. Here we've got a couple of recycling bins as well. It's really important to pick these out actually for you to be familiar with the fact that we do want to respect our learning environment here. We do want to look after it and it is a safe space for everybody and we would hate for that to be abused in any way. So please make sure that when you're here, if you do have any litter, you respect your environment by using the bins that are set out for you. Okay, we're now at the playground. Much like the field, the playground is in use at break times and for PE lessons. The field is obviously used for football, but the playground, we do have the basketball nets here for you to enjoy showing off your skills to your teachers and your friends, or equally embarrassing yourself completely if basketball is not the sport for you. It doesn't matter, I promise we won't laugh at you, I might. If playing sport isn't for you though, over here, under the canopy, when it starts to rain, you may want to enjoy just relaxing with your friends, just chilling out, just enjoying one of the two break times that you do have in the school day. We have our first break at 11 o'clock after periods 1 and 2, and we have our second break at 1:30 after periods 3 and 4. It makes sure that you are fully engaged in your learning in those classrooms that we've shown you in the Wilmington building. But now we're going to go and take a look in the main building. Okay, we're now in our main building. This is what is known as Main Street. We're just going to have a quick look down here because there's some very important offices and areas you need to be familiar with, and then we'll head back to our library. Okay, here's our main reception. You'll be introduced to some of those staff right now. Here's our reception. Okay, now we're going to head out front and we're going to take a look at PE. Okay, in here we have the smaller sports hall of our two sports halls. As you can see, it's currently being used for trampolining, one of the many various activities that take place both during PE and after school clubs. We're going to head to the other sports hall. Okay, before heading to the bigger sports hall, as you can see, we do have a learning area in here for BTEC and GCSE PE as well. One of the options that you can take here at Eastbury, and a fantastic option, might I add. Just through there, we have the bigger sports hall. Now, currently, it's being used for an after-school staff activity, which is badminton. So as we head in, we're going to try not to disturb them, and we're just going to have a look at that sports hall. Okay, here we are at our fitness studio. It's essentially a gym in the school, which is amazing, really. Each year group gets an opportunity to use that once a week, and you will obviously be using it during your PE lessons as well. We're gonna take a look inside.
Because it makes me feel physically fit and is good for my mental health. My favourite machine is the cross trainer.
I like doing PE in general, as Eastbury has great facilities like trampolining, and we also do athletics and rounders during the summer. G During winter, we do sports like netball for the girls and football for the boys, which are also the seasons where you can join clubs and you can verse other schools in the boroughs. And if you do so well, you can go to different cities and verse other schools.
Okay, so we're now about to leave PE. We're going to head back down to Main Street, but as we do, we're going to have a little look at what the main entrance of the school looks like. So if you as parents or guardians wish to ever visit the school, want to come in for meetings, etc., you're familiar with how it looks. When your parents do come into the school, you will check in at reception there, where you'll be greeted by one of our lovely reception staff. You might notice this table and chairs here. We often use our year eights as student secretaries, which means they have an opportunity, two students every day have a chance to run messages around the school that are given by very important people in the school via the office to ensure that everybody has access to any messages that they may need. Here we have Mr. Goy's office. An office you'll become familiar with is Mrs. Lastiota's office. She is our attached SLT link for Year 7 next year, so you'll get to know her.
Hello Year 7, welcome to Eastbury. I'm Mrs. Lastiotis. I'm the Assistant Head in charge of safeguarding, and I'm also the Assistant Head linked to your year group, so I'll be seeing a lot of you in September.
Right next to it is also another very important office. Attendance and punctuality is very important here at Eastbury, and if you ever find yourself with an appointment or you're late for any particular reason, please make sure that you have a note from home or parents or guardians have called in. And then when you do come into school, make sure you check in at this office so that they can mark you in, because your attendance mark is very important. We have classrooms along Main Street as well. As you can see, these are mainly used as drama rooms. And as you can see, these table and chairs are set out just more space for you to enjoy your free time. You are allowed to eat at these particular places. It is an extension from the canteen, which we'll have a look at a moment. But first, another very important room, a room that I hope a lot of you will use, particularly in your first year here at Eastbury. It's the library. Okay, so as you can see in here, we have a nice big library. Full of reading books, full of textbooks, all sorts of resources for your learning. As you can see in the middle there, we've got computers for you to access for any homework that you might like to do. At the back, you can see another one of our interactive screens and lots of tables and chairs there for many workshops that take place in this area. It really is an important learning environment, this one. It's a place that students come at break time. It's a place that you can come after school. It's a place that will be utilised in lesson time and, as I said, for workshops as well. I really do hope you make the most of this environment, because it is a fantastic resource to have here at the school. If you don't believe me, hopefully you'll believe some of the Year 7s that have experienced it this year.
Hi, I'm Esther Dede from 7E. A mini librarian. I like reading books because it's really fun and it helps me with my imagination. I also like the library because it has so many computers which I can use to do my work revise and print out stuff.
Hi, my name is Yahya Saibuddin and I'm in 7D. I really like the library as it's one of my favourite hobbies. I love reading books and losing my mind into them. Also, I work as a mini librarian. And there's even computers in this library where you can do your homework, and it's a really lovely place to be.
Hello, my name is Peppy. I'm from 7Y, and I was really nervous when I first came to Eastbury. And if you are as well, you really shouldn't be. Everyone's so friendly. A lot of new opportunities came up to make friends, meet new teachers. I got to boost my confidence, and everything was just amazing. That's why I really enjoy Eastbury, and I think you will too.
Hello, my name is Tom, and I'm in 7U. One of my favourite things about Eastbury Community School is the clubs, for example table tennis. I really enjoy playing table tennis, but it's really helped me progress and get better at learning from other people. That's one of my favourite things, and that's why I'm intrigued for Eastbury Community School.
This afternoon, I'm in Form 70. If you're worried about coming to Eastbury, you really shouldn't be, because Eastbury is a really loving community and everyone supports each other no matter what, where you're from or what you like to do. That's why I enjoy life at Eastbury, and I think you will too.
Okay, that was the library. Now we're going to head over to where you eat your lunch. And here we are at the canteen. This is where you're going to come at your designated break time to enjoy your lunch. Not much more to say to this other than the fact that this is most students' favourite room, I must say. Okay, as much as it being the students' favourite room, I've got to say it's a lot of our staff's favourite room as well. And when we've enjoyed our lunch, either at first break or second break, either way, there is still a lesson or two for us to experience afterwards. So we're going to make our way upstairs to see where you may be. Okay, as you can see, we're now upstairs at a very important part of the school, which is our learning support area. Should you ever require additional support with any of your subjects or with indeed anything around the school, this is the perfect area for you to come to. Not only have we got our area for SEN, but we've also got our Deaf ARP up here, which recently won an award for School of the Year for the provision that they provide for our deaf students. Really is an outstanding, friendly place to be, and should you ever need any additional support, this is where you would come. Okay, right, so there's your learning support area. Just this way are our ICT rooms. So we're just gonna take a look at how one of those looks so that you're familiar with those. Okay, so as you can see, this is one of our computer rooms. Enough computers for each of you to independently carry out your learning in both IT lessons. And again, much like the library, it can be used for any homework that you may wish to do as long as the teacher is happy for you to be here after school, which I know many of our staff are in order to encourage you to do your additional learning on top of what goes on in the school hours. Okay, we're now going to head back down to the first floor of this building where we're going to find the technology rooms. So let's go and take a look. Okay, so here we are at our hospitality and catering rooms. Let's take a look inside. Okay, as you can see in here, this is a particularly fun room. This is where you do your food technology. I'm led to believe that our year sevens this year were making pizzas, we're making apple crumbles, etc., all using these stoves, all using the resources available to them in here. I really do look forward to you being able to do the same so that you can come to me with free pizza and free apple crumble. Thanks a lot. Okay, on this floor we also have two more SLT offices. We have Miss Ward in this one and we have Mrs. Collins in this one, who is the head of secondary at the moment. So if ever you are needed by her, this is where you will come. Let's go this way. Okay, we're now in our technology area. There's an array of rooms here for various aspects of technology. We're just going to take a look inside one of them. This room in particular is for textiles. Okay, so this is one of our textiles room. For the creative ones amongst you, you're gonna absolutely love it in here. If you're not so creative, much like me, you're still gonna love it in here. Every time I come past this classroom, something fascinating's going on inside, something that I only wish I could do myself. We're now gonna move to another technology room. So head this way. Okay, we're now in a different area, still technology, but in a different area. A vastly different room, this one. Come and take a look. So as you can see, this is a very practical workshop that you've got here. This is where you're going to be doing your very hands-on DIY type stuff. The sort of thing that, again, my lack of creativity meant that I was completely useless at, but there are so many impressive things that go on here and so many students, and you're going to be one of them, impress me with the work that they do. I can't wait to see what you can make in this room over the next 5 years. Okay, we've now come back up the stairs that we originally went down to carry on looking at technology. We're now heading to a different part of the school. This is our sixth form area. So, one thing I will say, sixth form is milling around here. Hopefully so many of you will be lucky enough to attend our sixth form when you get the GCSE results that you need in order to be in this part of the building. But we do also have our languages area here. So we're gonna head over and look at one of those classrooms. Okay, so this is one of the classrooms where you will be doing French, Spanish, and any languages at GCSE level in particular that you feel keen on taking as a GCSE, you speak to Mr. Smith and he will get that arranged for you. A real fantastic department. And as I said, we are in the sixth form area. So although this is one of the classrooms, when we head back out, you're about to see what the sixth form area looks like. So be careful when you're milling around here. They're a lot bigger than you at the moment. Let's go. So as you can see, this is our common room of the sixth form area. This is where our sixth formers have the opportunity to just chill out, have a chat and study in between their lesson time. That's a long way away for you, but everything you're working towards is hopefully going to end up here. Let's head back. Okay, so you've familiarised yourself with that side of this building. As we make our way around, we're going to now look at a couple of the music rooms and also the art rooms, if you'd like to come with me. Okay, before we head all the way around, I would like to point out the YCC Hub. If you understand this reference, you may be watching this after the tournament has ended. I really hope it did come home. This YCC Hub, it holds most of the YCCs, most of the heads of year. You won't often find me in here because I do sit myself in Wilmington where I have my own classroom for you to come and access me whenever you like, as long as I'm not teaching at the time. So if there's any a break time issue that you may have, come and see me over there. Or if you can't find me, come and see the YCC Hub and one of our YCCs will very kindly guide you towards me. Let's carry on. Just stopping here, down there, there's another load of computer rooms, exactly the same as the ones that you saw upstairs. So when you do your ICT, you'll be situated either on this floor or the floor above. Let's keep going. Okay, here we are in one of our music rooms. As you can see, it's currently set out for what looks like a keyboard lesson, but you've also got the drum kit at the back there. You've got the guitars on the walls that you've just seen. If you just speak to our fantastic music department about any instruments that you are interested in playing, they will certainly see what they can do for you. As a result, what we also have are concerts put on at Christmas and in the summer. They are absolutely fantastic. We have staff attending them. Your parents and guardians can come and attend them. But most importantly, it is you that are putting on the show, representing your school, representing your families. It's fantastic every single time. So if you are musical, make sure that you engage in our music department. Show us what you can do. And if you're not musical, look at this. This is the chance for you to enjoy that.
My name is JJ and I'm in year seven. I go to Eastbury School and I really like doing music. I come to this room every day. I break, first break, second break I do basketball, I mean. And I start playing
drums. Yusuf, and I like DJing. It helps me a lot to relieve a lot of my anger sometimes.
And I'm also Yusuf and I like to DJ to just like have fun and yeah, have like entertain myself with my friends. Yeah.
Okay, we've now made our way to the art classrooms. We're going to take a look inside this one. Let's go. Okay, this is another one of the rooms that I walk past in absolute awe and envy of the work that the students can produce in here. As you can see by the work that you're seeing on the walls, absolutely fantastic stuff goes on in here. I only wish that it's the sort of thing that I could produce. We've got fantastic teachers guiding you through both your Key Stage 3 art subjects and also when you get to GCSE, you have the opportunity to engage in photography as well. A different form of art, but equally as impressive. Really impressive room, really impressive department this one. Let's go back.
As part of your transition programme, you would have been sent three transition guides. A Time of Opportunity, All About Me and the Summer of Fun transition guide. You would have also received a coat of arms project and also a coral reef project. We would really, really like you to bring all of those projects in with you when you join us in September. There's going to be lots of rewards and lots of prizes, and we of course cannot wait to learn all about you and see the wonderful work that you've been doing.
Okay, As you can see, we've arrived back at the gate that you will enter through. This is also the gate that you will exit through. This is called the Roslyn Gate. As you've seen, as we've gone around the school in this video, there is so much available to you to meet all of your needs. If you're someone that's a maths enthusiast, we've got top maths classrooms there, nice and big, nice and spacious for you to engage in your learning. If you're on the more of the creative side, we've got wonderful art classrooms, a technology department where you can show us and show us your skills and show us what you can do. If sport is for you, then we've got fantastic resources and availability of in the field, in the playground, the trampolining that you saw, the badminton that you saw. We run futsal clubs here after school. There is so much available here for you. I can't wait to meet you in September. I can't wait to see how much you can impress me and how much you can impress us as a school and how much you can represent your family as positively as I know each and every one of you can. Be proud to be here at Eastbury. I look forward to seeing you in September. See you then.